Hello everyone, welcome to BizOrTech. We are into the final video, which is the final section of problem solving in the data sufficiency. So before proceeding further, let's look at the directions for these questions. From 11 to 15, in each of the following problems, there is one question and three statements, 1, 2 and 3, given below the op question. Then what you are supposed to do, you have to decide whether the data given in the statement is sufficient to answer the question. So here only three statements will be given. Read all the statements carefully and find out which of the statement is sufficient, or if there are many, which are the statements which are sufficient to answer the question, and choose the correct alternative in each question. So let's look into the question. How will this be visible? In which year was Sanjay born? Okay, so now in order to get that answer, we have three statements. How many statements will be required? Sanjay is 6 years older than Gopal. So whatever the age of Gopal, Sanjay should be 6 years older. Then Gopal's brother was born in 1982. And then the next thing, Sanjay's brother is 2 years younger than Gopal's brother, who was 8 years younger than Gopal. So you have three statements. Now your job is, which are all the statements which will be sufficient in order to get the answer that in which year Sanjay was born. And you have 1 and 2 or 1, 3 or all three of them. So let's determine that with the solution. So let's begin with the solution. From statement 2, we know that the Gopal's brother was born in 1982. And then from statement 3, we have Gopal's brother was 8 years younger to him. So that is, Gopal should be 8 years younger to, the Gopal's brother was 8 years younger to Gopal. So younger in the sense, the age should go backwards. So 1982, Gopal's brother was born. So Gopal was born in 8 years younger, which is 1974. And next, from this we have statement 1. We find that Sanjay is 6 years older than Gopal. So definitely 6 years older than, he should be 6 years before the Gopal, which is 1968. And Sanjay was born in the year 1968. And now you just have to answer how many statements were sufficient. So in order to get this answer, you require all 3, 1, 2 and 3. So choosing the right answer option D will serve the purpose. And now let's go on to the next problem. 4 subjects, physics, chemistry, mathematics and biology, were taught in 4 consecutive periods of 1 hour each, starting from 8 a.m. At what time was the chemistry period scheduled? So we have to determine chemistry, when was it scheduled, if the classes are starting at 8 a.m. and for 1 hour as a mandatory time. Now mathematics period ended at 10 a.m. So that means mathematics started at 9, right? Next, which was preceded by biology. So that means 8 biology started, 8 to 9 bio, 9 to 10 mathematics. Very clear. Now are we able to determine chemistry? Not just with 1. Next, physics was scheduled in the last period. So that gives us the very right conclusion. At 11 physics is scheduled. So 11 to 12 is physics, and in between the first, before that we have chemistry. So chemistry should be starting at 10. Rightly said. So now, anyways, not just with 2 we will be able to solve. Both of them are required as of now. Now, mathematics period was immediately followed by chemistry. So now, with this, we will see which are the different 4 options we have. So now, how do we determine chemistry is enough? From 1 and 2, we conclude that mathematics period began at 9 a.m. Biology period began at 8 a.m. and physics period began at 11 a.m. So the chemistry period began at 10 a.m. So as I explained you, it's right. Next, from 1 and 3, we conclude that mathematics period ended and chemistry period began at 10 a.m. So definitely here only 1 and either 2 or 3. So 1 and 2, in 2 or 3, any 1, and in 1 is definitely required because we have to get when mathematics is started. So the right answer option is option D. Only 1, and in 2 or 3, any one of them, if they are included, will be able to solve the given problem. So that's about problem 2. Now let's look into problem number 13. Who is the tallest among 6 boys, PT and TQ and R? So it should be definitely very easy. So let's follow the method that I had told you. P is taller than D. Okay, P is taller than D. And N, but not as tall as T. Okay, P is taller than both D and N, but not as tall as T. So T should be here. R is taller than Q, but not as tall as T. So R is taller than Q, but not as tall as T. So R and Q should definitely come below T. Maybe in any of this place, because we don't know. Q is not taller than T and R. So Q is not taller than T and R. So Q should definitely come below R. So now with this, who's the tallest? Were we able to determine that? So let's look into the option. From one, we have the given option. So that is P is taller than T and P is taller than N. And T is taller than P. So that is T is the first standing, then P, then D, and then N. And from two, we have R is taller than Q and T is taller than R. That is T is taller than both R and Q. So with both the statements, we conclude T is greater than Q and R is greater than Q. So clearly from 1 and 2 we conclude that T is taller than each one of P and D, R and Q. So T is the tallest. Third statement is not required. Third statement is required maybe in order to place Q. So definitely only 1 and 2. So that's about problem number 13. Now let's move on to problem number 14. What is the total monthly salary of Vasu? Okay, you have different statements for that. Vasu's basic salary is 100 more than Rajan's salary, who also serves in Vasu's company. First thing, then. Other allowances drawn by Rajan besides his basic salary are rupees 2000 per month, which is rupees 50 less than Vasu's salary. So if Rajan is drawing 2000, Vasu's salary should be 2050. Anyways, Rajan's basic salary is rupees 1550 per month. So let me explain this to you in solution. So we have four different options. Anyways, they stay as common. So now from statement 3, we have Rajan's basic salary as 1550. And next, from 1, we have Vasu's basic salary is 100 rupees more than Rajan's salary. So that should be 1650. And if you look at 2, we have Rajan's other allowances is rupees 2000, which is 50 less than Vasu. So Vasu's salary should be rupees 2050. Now add Vasu's salary and Rajan's salary. You can definitely make out. Therefore, Vasu's monthly salary is 1650 plus 2050, which is 3700. We were able to determine with help of all 1, 2, and 3. So here, in order to solve problem D, we require all three statements 1, 2, and 3. And now let's move on to the last problem. What does CUM represent in a code language? So you can directly go with the solving here. So here also CUM is there, here also CUM is there. So if there is a common CUM in both the statement, you will be able to get the answer from that anyways. So now let's look into the solution part. To find the code for CUM, we need to have two statements which have one common code word and CUM as the common word, which is there in 1 and 3. So in statement 1 and 3, CUM is there, here, 1, here. And then a common code should also be there. So if you consider that, NA is there. See, so we will be able to determine with the help of option 1 and 3. So only 1 and 3 are required. And that is how you determine whether the given data is sufficient to solve the given problem. So with this problem, I'll be wrapping up the data sufficiency discussion, and in our next videos we will solve problems and concepts based on different exciting topics and very interesting topics. So that's about data sufficiency, and if you have any doubts, please drop your doubts in the comment section, and thank you so much for watching.